Good morning students, hope everyone are fine, right? So in the last class I have sent on PDF, that is about the exercise number 2.2 only, and 6th one also solved, 7th to 10th main I told to solve, I will solve in the next class, right? So in this class we will discuss the 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th problem. Even 11th, 12th, 13th also I sent as a PDF only. That is also very easy. Just greater than or lesser than. Okay, comparison is there. You know how to compare the values. Which one is a greater, which one is not a greater, like that. Okay. So now we will continue the 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th main 2.2. After that we will discuss the 2.3. Okay. So now open the exercise number 2.2. Exercise number 2.2 in that 7th main. Okay. So what is the 7th question they given here? Both opening batsmen together scored a 2/3 of a total run scored by a team. However, Irfan has scored only 1/3 of the what opening batsmen scored together. So how many runs were scored by Irfan alone if the total score of the team was 333? Okay, so what is the total score here? First write, total score is 333. So what is the total score here? 333 runs, right? So next thing is here, both opening batsmen together scored 2/3 of the total runs, right? So now write here, runs scored by, runs scored by opening batsman, or write here both, okay, both the opening batsman, that is equal to 2/3 of the total run. 2/3 of the total run. Right? So 2/3 of a total means, of means here multiplication. What is the total run here given? 333. Right? Now cancel the values. 3 ones are here, 3 ones are, 3 ones are, 3 ones are. Right? Now multiply here. 2 ones are 2, here 2 ones are 2, here 2 ones are 2. So what is the run scored by both the opening batsmen? The run scored by, right here, run scored by both the opening batsmen is equal to 222. Right? Now again, see here, Irfan has scored only 1/3 of the what opening batsman scored together. So Irfan scored here 1/3 of this run, right? So Irfan scored 1/3 of this run means 2 here. That is a run scored by, run scored by Irfan, that is equal to 1/3 of this 222. That is nothing but a, do the simplification, of means multiplication, 222. Is there any cancellation? Yes. Here, 3 ones are, 3 sevens are 21, 1 left, again 3 fours are, right? So how many scored by Irfan alone? Irfan, where I have to write here, here I have, last sentence of it, therefore Irfan, therefore Irfan scored 74 runs alone. Okay, he scored 74 runs alone. Getting everyone? So like this we have to do the problem. Try to understand the question properly first, after that the what we have to do here. Okay, so what they told here, both the opening batsmen together scored 2/3 of the total runs. Total run is nothing but 333. So the runs scored by the both the opening batsman is 2/3 of the total runs. means 2 by 3 of the total one, that will be the 333. Cancel the values, 3 ones are here, 3 111 are. So now multiply, you will get a 222 here. Means run scored by the both the opening batsmen, that is 222, right? Next, run scored by the Irfan. What is the run scored by Irfan? Fraction they given only. 1/3 of the opening batsman score. What is the opening batsman score? That is 222. Okay, so 1/3 of the that much is scored by the Irfan. So run scored by Irfan is equal to 1/3 of the 222. So now we cancel the values here. 3 ones are 3 sevens are 1 left, 3 fours are 12. So what is the run scored by Irfan? Irfan scored 74 runs alone. That means. Okay, so we finished the 7th main now. Now we'll go for the 8th one. What is the 8th question they given here? Read the 8th one. Raghu completed 12 by 15th of his maths homework in 30 minutes. Seema completed 3 by 4 of what Raghu had completed in the same amount of time. Okay. What fraction of a maths homework did Seema complete in 30 minutes they are asking. Read the question once again properly here. See the Raghu completed 12 by 15th of his maths homework in 30 minutes. Seema completed 3 by 4 of what Raghu completed in the same amount of time. Okay. Then what fraction of a maths homework did Seema complete in 30 minutes they are asking. So first find the difference between those two. That means what? In half an hour, Raghu completed 12 by 15th of the maths homework. And Seema completed 3 by 4th of the Raghu completed. Okay. So first find those two values. After that, get a subtract. Okay. Then after that, what we have to do? What fraction of a maths homework did Seema complete in the 30 minutes they are asking? Okay. We'll see. Okay, so here in 30 minutes homework completed by Raghu. Is 12 by 15, right? So in 30 minutes homework complete by the Raghu is 12 by 15 fraction they given here. Next, again Seema completed 3 by 4 of the what Raghu completed in the same amount of time. Same amount of time is 30 minutes only. Then they asked what fraction of a maths homework did Seema complete in the 30 minutes. Now right here, in 30 minutes, homework completed by Seema, that is equal to 3 by 4 of Raghu's. 3 by 4 of a Raghu. It means what? What is the Raghu fraction here? 12 by 15, right? That one. 3 by 4 off means multiplication, here 12 by 15. Now cancel the values here. 4 ones are, 4 threes are here. Here 3 ones are, 3 fives are. What is the left thing here? 3 by 5. Right? So, what fraction completed by Seema here? Seema completed 3 by 5 of the maths homework. Right here. Therefore, Seema completed 3 by 5 of the maths homework. Okay. 3 by 5 of the maths homework. This is the fraction. 3 by 5 is the fraction of the sema. Okay. So now we'll go for the ninth problem. What is the ninth one? Read the question, everyone. Ninth one, a hill 101 integer 1 by 3 meter in a height has 1/4 of its height under a water, and what is the 1/4 of its height is under a water, and what is the height of a hill is visible above the water, they are asking. Okay, see here, total height of a hill is how much? Total height of a hill, that is the ninth one, right? Yes, total height of a hill is 101 integer 1 by 3 meter. That means what? Just convert into an improper fraction. 3 ones are 3 here. Okay, next 3 0 here. 3 plus 1 is equal to 304. 304 divided by 3 meter, right? This is the height of the hill. Now, again, next thing is here. 1 by 4th of a height of is under the water. Okay, so the hill is like this. Okay, so inside this is a 1/4 here, 1/4 height. Here water is there. Okay, here water is there, and how many left here? 3 by 4, right? 1/4 is under the water means 3/4 is above the water. Above the water, right? 3/4 of a height of a hill is above the water. That means, so here, right here, 1/4 of the hill is under the water. Okay, so which is implied that 3/4 of the height of right here. 1/4 of the height of a hill here. 3/4 of the height of a hill is above the water. Right? So therefore 3/4 of 304 divided by 4 meter. Okay, so we have to find the 3/4 fraction, not 1/4, because 1/4 is the under the water. We are finding the above the water. This is a water level here. Okay, so above the water is nothing but the 3/4. Here 1/4 is under the water. It means what? 3/4 is the above the water. Okay, so 3/4, we want the that height only here. 3/4 of the total height, that will be the 304/4. Now do the problem. That is 3/4 into 304 divided by 4. Is there any cancellation? Now observe here. 4 7s are 28. 2 left. 4 6s are 24. Right? Again, 4 1s are 3 left. 4 9s are 36. 19 3s are how much? 57 meter. Okay, so what we can say here, right here, the height of the hill, therefore, where we can write here, okay, therefore, height of a hill above the water is 57 meter. Okay, height of a hill above the water is 57 meter. Getting everyone? Yes. So now 10th one. Start the 10th one. Okay. So what is the 10th question? Read everyone. That is, Dronika reads a book for 1 integer 3/4 hours every day, and she reads the entire book in 6 days. Okay, so how many hours in all were required by her to read the book, they are asking. Okay, see here, per day 1 hour 3/4 hours she will read. It means she reads the entire book in 6 days. So how many hours in all were required by her to read the book they are asking. Okay. So first find the per day. Per day how many hour she will read, that we have to find first. After that multiply with the 6, you will get the answer here. So do the 10th one now. Monica reads a book for 182 3/4 hour per day. Right? Next, we want the total hours in a 6 days. Right? So, total time for a 6 days. Is equal to question mark. That will be the 6 into 1 integer 3/4. So here 6 into 4 ones are 4. 4 plus 3 is 7. 7/4. Here 2 twos are. Here 2 threes are. 21/2. That will be the 10 integer 1/2 hour. Okay. So in a 6 days, how many hours she took here? 10 hour. It means 1/2 means half an hour. So she took a 10 and half an hour to read that whole book here. Okay, this is the answer, final answer. So we finished the exercise number 2.2, because 11th, 12th and 13th I sent as a PDF. So just see that one, that will be a very easy only. Okay, by seeing the answers you come to know that what is there in that topic. Okay, so directly we will move to the next topic, that is 2.3, that is about the division of a fractions. Okay, so same division of a fraction is also nothing but the same multiplication only, just we have to write the, instead of writing a division symbol we have to write the multiplication symbol, and after that take a reciprocal of the next number. After that only one step is different in a division, further all the steps are similar to the multiplication, nothing is changed here. Okay, so we'll begin the division of the fractions. 2.3. Divisions. Okay, in that first main. What is the first main? First main, first question. 4/6 divide with the 1/6. Okay. So whenever there is a division is there, just you have to write as a multiplication. See here 4/6 is there, right? So instead of writing a division, we have to write the multiplication. And next term, what is the next term here? 1/6. So take the reciprocal of this number. What is the reciprocal meaning? Reciprocal means just to exchange the numerator to denominator, denominator to numerator. Here denominator is 6 and numerator is 1. So just exchange these two, that will be the 6/1. Okay? Because of we are writing the division as a multiplication, for that reason we have to take reciprocal of the next number, not first number. Okay? So whenever you are writing the division as a multiplication, just take the reciprocal of the second number. Okay, so I write the reciprocal of the second number here. Now cross cancellation. Now only this step is different. After that all that are similar to the multiplication only. Now see here, 6 ones are, here 6 ones are. 4 into 1 is 4 and 1 into 1 is 1. What is the answer? 4/1 is the answer. Getting everyone? So like this we have to do the division problems. Okay, we will solve the second one now. What is the second question here? that is 4 by 7 divided with the 2 by 7 here. 2 by 7. Okay. See, again, as I told, just convert the division as the multiplication here. That is 4 by 7 into 7 by 2. Whenever you are writing a multiplication, just take the reciprocal of this number. That is 7 by 2 here. Next, 7 ones are here. 7 ones are 2 ones are 2 twos are. Again, 2 into 1 is 2. 1 into 1 is 1. This is the answer. Getting everyone? Yes. Now we do the third problem. Third one. 9 by 10 divided with the 1 by 10. See, same like that only. 9 by 10. Write the division as the multiplication. Reciprocal of this number means 10 by 1 here. 10 ones are here. 9 into 1 is 9. 1 into 1 is 1. 9 by 1 or else 9. Both are correct. Okay. So answer is 9 or 9 by 1. Next, the fourth one. Do the fourth problem. What is the fourth one here? 6 by 10. 6 by 10 divided with the 1 by 5. Right. So same. Here also same thing. 6 by 10 into 5 by 1. 5 ones are 5 twos are. Again 2 ones are 2 threes are. So 3 into 1 is 3. 1 into 1 is 1. Or else we can write only 3 as the answer. Getting? Next, fifth one. Fifth one. 6 by 9 divided with the 1 by 3. Same thing again. 6 by 9 into 3 by 1. 3 ones are 3 threes are. Again 3 ones are 3 twos are. So 2 into 1 is 2. 1 into 1 is 1. That is 2. Answer is 2 here. Last problem of the first week. Sixth one, they given. 8 by 12 divided with the 3 by 7. Okay. So 8 by 12 into 7 by 3. Is there any cancellation? I think no. Here cancellation is there. 2 4s are 2 6s are. Next. Again 2 2s are 2 3s are. So 2 into 7 is 14. 3 into 3 is 9. 14 by 9 is the answer. 14 by 9 is the answer. Okay. So similarly, second main, third main, fourth main, they given here. Same like this only we have to solve that second, third, fourth main. Okay. So homework is solve the second main, third main, fourth main. That is the homework for you. Okay. We'll continue in the next class. Thank you everyone.